I experimented with marijuana a time or two, and I didn't like it. And didn't inhale, and never thought it could be.
There's no reason for it to ever have been made illegal.
Dangerous. Right.
Marijuana being sold at every corner.
Gross.
There has not been one documented death due to marijuana.
I inhaled. That was the point.
I'm reviewing homegrown strains. This is like my 8th homegrown strain from Illinois. Now granted, everybody's still staying anonymous. Let's face it, I don't really have a big following yet. But when I do, people are going to be begging. 20 years, people are still not begging. But anyways, the strain I have today is Blackberry OG. It's an indica dominant strain. It's great for pain relief and for sleeping. Probably stimulate your appetite as well. However, when I vape, it usually doesn't stimulate my appetite as much versus when I smoke. If you're trying to avoid the munchies, you can also take CBD after smoking and it will eliminate that. So if you're worried about weight gain, which I feel like most stoners are usually not, but again, there's always exceptions. It smells really good. I would love to have a pillow to sleep with this at night. It's like a pungent-y berry. Not in the way that a berry goes bad, too. It's just spicy berry, maybe it'd be better, or a zesty berry. Vape set to almost 420. I hope you guys and gals had a good 420. It's been crazy with everything going on, but again, 420 is more so a stay-at-home holiday. First legal 420 in Illinois. It's kind of a bummer, but it won't be the last. Hopefully there'll be speakeasies for the next one. Or not speakeasies, but 420 lounges, say you will, where, you know, maybe it'll allow you to bring your own green and they have a dab lounge. Then you actually be able to meet like-minded social stoners. You don't have to closet smoke. It won't be downtown, that's for sure, because downtown can't even have dispensaries. Think you're gonna have a pot lounge? Hell no! It actually tastes how it smells. Usually it's humulene or geranial are the two most dominant terps. I feel like when it's humulene dominant, it's more sativa, whereas when it's more geranial dominant, it's more of that indica. But again, it also depends on the trichome profile and its phenotype. I'm going to be experimenting with companion planting with my next grow. Alfalfa growing with me, I'll have basil growing, I'll have lemongrass, as well as, what else am I having? Marigolds, that's right, fucking flowers. Flowers upon flowers. And they're beneficial because those plants that I just listed help repel insects or bad insects, and they actually help bring good insects, which obviously I'm growing inside, so had encounters with thrips before. Up close, they're terrible. They literally shit on your weed. But an easy way to get rid of them is you get predatory mites and you put sand as topsoil. She's a lot harsher. The longer you cure a strain, the better it will get, or the smoother it will get. Still pretty harsh, but I mean, overall, he did a great job growing it. I mean, it was smooth in the vaporizer. The taste, however, wasn't as flavorful as the others I've had in the past. If I review this strain another 3 months and he continues to burp it or cure it, I guarantee this is gonna be super flavorful. And it could also be the genetics, who knows? I can't really say my sentence is right now.
I have no idea what's going on.
With our powers combined, I summon, it went out. My vaporizer at least doesn't go out. Till next time, thanks for tuning in. Remember, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And again, if you have any comments, anything you like, you didn't like, put below. And if you want to be on my show, you want me to review your medicine, give me a shout out. I'll be more than happy to. Review your grow, maybe. Hopefully you don't have bugs, because I don't want to put bugs in my grow. Until next time, see you soon.